GTV Africa from.
Oh yes.
What are we?
We are the same group.
We are from this country.
Oh yes.
Nigerians.
We cannot let them be a slave in our father's land.
Yes.
We are educated.
Yes.
We went to the same school with the regular people.
Yes.
We need so to call any people.
Yes.
Some of us are better than
the
others.
The same school.
Some of us, we study them with first class.
Yes.
Some of them are with children.
Yes.
We were better than some of them when we were in school.
Yes.
We went to the same school, the same education. To the same education as well. Is it easy?
No.
Easy. We have to be as good as ourselves. We cannot even be a better in our father's land. We can't even be a slave in America! We can't even be a slave in America!
Solidarity forever! Solidarity forever! Solidarity forever! With our own way, my brother!
Solidarity forever!
Solidarity
We are on live to GTV Africa from the office of SCF, where the people that are deformed are making the protest. And the protest, they are not taking it lightly. They've already taken over the entrance of the SGF. They are at the SGF protesting, and I'm going to find out why they are protesting. May I find out the leader of this group, please?
Who are you?
I'm a journalist.
From which newspaper?
From GTV Africa.
All right. Yes. This is Arikoto.
Okay.
I'm the leader of the group.
Okay.
And it's quite unfortunate that we find ourselves in this situation. It is quite unfortunate that our people are not put in the right place. It's quite unfortunate that we have to suffer in our father's land during the time of elections that are going to call us to vote.
As a Nigerian.
But when the soup is prepared, then we are beggars. You can just imagine. This is a coalition of two disability groups. Transnational and National of Technology in Climate Change Crisis of Nigeria. People are dying. Our members are committing suicide because there is no job. We wrote to the SDA. On September 7, we made a protest to this place.
Last year.
Last year, 2020.
Yes.
We are the disability driven. They perform their work anyway, let me put that way. On October 7, we are invited for a meeting by the SDA. Through this man, PS Political. And the SSA. Permit me to call the SSA when it was called on disability. He said, even. Official cards don't even be given to me. That's why I cannot attend that meeting. So it was the PS Political that addressed that meeting. And we told him our plight, that this is the problem we are passing through. I said, okay, he added over to the director that we should discuss. And whatever comes out of the meeting, they're going to implement it. Since the office is to implement policies of government. At that meeting, we agreed, one, that the list of unemployed members in our group should be compiled. Two, that those who are, what can I put it, like say 40 upwards, if they need a loan or a grant, that they are going to write to financial institutions. And we were given a form to fill. We went back home and all members were contacted, which we did. And we submitted the following week. That was just ending of the month, October.
Last year.
Till now, nothing has been done. Yes, on a personal level, I was contacting the PS. What is happening? He said, he cannot write to financial institutions. But that was our agreement. I told him, even if it's 10 people you can blood, even if it's 20, it's something. And we know they are employing. They are employed. People are getting employed. Okay, we've written letters, no positive response. Well, that should be the case. We have written severally. We now came here now. The PS is telling us that there is no job. That means he's telling us that we should go and die if we want to die. And that is not good because he is getting salary. He's getting salary that we should be, as at yesterday, 3 days ago, somebody committed suicide. Because what is it when there is nothing? You are now saying you cannot go and create job. Are you telling us to, okay,
we should go and die if we want to die.
Go to hell.
They are in the offices now.
Things are not going to die.
We are Nigerians. I think what he needs to do now is to order the security to kill us.
Does.
That's all. That's all. And it will give him glory. That's it. But one thing is, this is the government office. It's a public office. So if they are not assisted, the security are doing their job. They locked us out. Fine. Because they believe. You know, it's not their problem. He is saying that he is disabled. May he not be a disabled person. Because of the simple something that happened in his hand. So that's why I said he's disabled. If he's disabled, if he's on wheelchair thoroughly, he will not know what to do. We are here. Whatever he wants to do. We are not saying that every member should be employed. We are not saying everybody should be. You are not telling us we should go and get 10,000. Look at imagine. For goodness sake, we say we should 10,000 naira. You see the problem we meet ourselves. You meet the problem we meet ourselves. So that's no problem. We are, my dear people, I've addressed the first. You see, what the PS has in mind is this. Maybe it's a Yoruba man or whatever. If it's a Yoruba man, it's quite unfortunate. It's very unfortunate. And you expect his subordinates to support him. There's no big deal about that. What he said was that we should go places. If we like, let us die here. But one day, he will leave that seat.
Yes.
That is the truth. One day, he will remember this day. What's today's day? What's the day we talk? Whether he likes it or not. But we are not living here. He can order, he has the power to order the security.
He
has the order, no problem. That's it. But we are here, we don't live here. Please, my dear. Are we tired?
No! We are coming!
No! So, please.
From GTV Africa, this is what I can bring for you from the office of SGA.